Hello dear students, in this video we will look validation parameter, that is accuracy, and we will see all the calculations in Excel. Like the video and subscribe the channel. So firstly we will see the procedure to prepare an aliquots. Weigh accurately 100 mg of standard substance of paracetamol. And we need to know this relationship, that is 1 milligram it is equivalent to 1000 microgram. Dissolve 100 milligram of paracetamol in 1000 ml of 0.1 normal NaOH solution. So stock solution of paracetamol, it will be 1000 ppm solution or 1000 microgram per ml solution. So let's see the by calculation. 100 milligram we have taken and we have dissolved in 100 ml. So if we solve this equation, it will be milligram per ml. So milligram it is now converted to microgram, 1 milligram it will be converted to microgram, so it becomes 1000 microgram per ml or 1000 ppm solution. So this will be the stock 1 solution, and from above stock solution take 10 ml and dilute up to 100 ml with 0.1 normal NaOH solution, and so it will be 1000 ppm solution. So we have taken 10 ml and we have dissolved in 100 ml, and into a concentration of 1000 microgram per ml or 1000 ppm, and resulting we will get 100 ppm solution or 100 microgram per ml solution. So after that we need to prepare some percentage level with 80 100 and 120, so I will explain in the next slide. Before that we need to also prepare for an accuracy purpose, we need, or recovery studies, we need to understand this tablet formulation, stock solution of tablet formulation. So for that, weigh accurately 20 tablets of marketed formulation having a paracetamol 500 milligram. As dose of paracetamol it is 500, so I have written 500 over there. Whatever it will be on your label claim having a paracetamol individual, so you write. After that, calculate the average weight. So I will show you in Excel how to calculate the average weight and how to calculate that equivalent weight. Now here you understand that we have to accurately weigh 100 milligram of equivalent weight. So not directly powder we have to weigh 100 milligram, we have to weigh 100 milligram of an equivalent weight. So I will explain in Excel how to weigh this 100 milligram of an equivalent weight of a paracetamol from a formulation. Dissolve this 100 milligram equivalent weight of powder in 100 ml of 0.1 normal NaOH solution. So it will prepare a stock solution of 1000 microgram per ml. As we have seen earlier the calculations, take above stock solution, from that take 10 ml and dilute up to 100 ml. So we will get next stock solution, that is 100 ppm solution. Now we are in Excel. So we need to calculate the equivalent weight of a paracetamol, that is 100 milligram. So for that purpose we have taken 20 tablet and I have done the weight in milligram of 20 tablet. Now I need to calculate an average. For calculation of an average, press equal to and press AVE, and after that select the cell. For selecting such type of cell, also press shift control and then enter. So the average weight, it is 752 milligram. So 752 milligram is an average weight, 0.65 milligram. It's an average weight of a tablet. Now we have to take an 100 milligram equivalent weight. For that purpose, press equal to, make a bracket, write 752.65 into 100, complete the bracket, divided by 500, because label claim it's the 500. So this will be the equivalent weight of 100 milligram of an paracetamol, that is 150.53 milligram of powder you have to take to prepare 100 ml 100 ppm stock solution, that as we have seen in the procedure. Now both API or standard as well as in tablet formulation, both 100 ppm solutions are ready. Now we have to prepare for recovery studies or for accuracy study. We have to prepare 80, 100 and 120% solution from a tablet formulation. So follow this table for level, percent level 80, 100 and 120. From stock solution of a tablet formulation, pipette out 1 ml that is from 100 ppm and 0.8 ml from 100 ppm from standard stock solution of a paracetamol, and dilute up to 100 ml with 0.1 normal NH, it will give 18 ppm. So we will see the calculation. See, as we have taken 0.8 ml from a standard stock solution of a paracetamol and 1 ml from a tablet formulation, and we have dissolved in 10 ml, and the concentration of the both solution, it was 100 microgram per ml or 100 ppm solution, and due to which we have got 18 ppm last solution. So similarly, for 100% you have to take 1 ml from 100 ppm of tablet formulation and 1 ml from 100 ppm of stock paracetamol, standard stock paracetamol solution, and you will get 20 ppm. Similarly, you make for 22 ppm by pipetting out 1.2 ml standard stock solution and 1 ml of a tablet formulation stock solution. And such you make three of each level, means 18 ppm 3 concentration, 20 ppm 3 concentration and 22 ppm 3 concentrations. After that we will see. Now this is the table for recovery studies or accuracy. So concentration taken, it was 18 ppm, that is 80%. Concentration taken, it is 20 ppm, that is 100%. Concentration taken, it is 120%, that is 22 ppm. So we have taken three such kind of an, we have made such three kind of an concentration of 18 ppm, 20 ppm and 22 ppm respectively. So now we need to calculate the absorbance on a machine. After recording successfully on the machine absorbance of concentration, so I've got the absorbance. Now I need to calculate the concentration found. So for this purpose we have done earlier practical, that was linearity. So here the data it is. So in the linearity we have got the regression equation, that is y is equal to mx plus c. See, linearity and range, this equation or this data, it will be required in almost all the practicals, because this line equation, it is needed for to determine and concentration. So we have rearranged the equation, that is x equal to y minus c divided by m. Y it is absorbance as we are having it, m it is slope, we have calculated it, or either you can calculate over here also separately. And after that, x we need to find out, and c it is y intercept. So here in equation it is given what is that value of an y. So I will copy the value from here. If suppose you don't want to utilize this equation, or if it is difficult to utilize this equation and rather you want to find separately this slope and intercept value, you can find it directly through an Excel also. So press equal to and type slope. So here you will get slope, and see here known y's and known x. So known y's are absorbance and known x they are concentration. So select known y's firstly, put a comma, and then known x. So known x it is concentration, and press enter. So you will get the same value as it is given in equation. And for intercept similarly, press equal to and then intercept. known Ys and known X again similar fashion, that firstly absorbance, press comma, and then concentration. So you will get the similar values as given in equation for slope and intercept. From earlier practical, we have got the regression equation of linearity and range, and we have got the values of slope and intercept from it. And now we need to find out the concentration. So to find out the concentration, utilize this formula, y is equal to x is equal to y minus c divided by m. So y it is absorbance, put a bracket firstly, absorbance minus c is y intercept, that is 0.0115. put it manually, then only calculations will be right. And the value of slope, that is m divided by 0.0391. So I got the concentration, it was 18.02 for the first dilution, and scroll down, you will get the values. If you want to reduce the digit, you can reduce it from here, either you can increase the digit from here also. A similar fashion for 100% also, you calculate, press equal to, then bracket absorbance minus c 0.0115, bracket complete, divided by slope 0.0391. Now select the cell and scroll it down. In similar fashion, I have calculated for 120% also, and I have got the found concentration in this range. After that, we need to find the mean concentration. So for that purpose, press equal to average AVE. Now select the cell and you will get the average. And for standard deviation of a concentration, press equal to standard deviation STDEV, press on it and select the cell. You will get the standard deviation, and similar way you can calculate for this 100% and 120%. By using similar formula, I have calculated mean concentration as well as in standard deviation for 100% and 120%. Now we need to calculate percentage recovery. So for calculation of a percentage recovery, this is the formula, that is 100 into mean concentration found and concentration taken. So that will give a percentage recovery. So let us try for that formula. Press equal to, then 100 into mean concentration found. So select the cell, mean concentration found, and divide it by concentration taken. So we have taken 18 ppm. So I will write 18. So we have got 100.23% recovery. For 100%, now we will see the recovery. Hundred into mean concentration found divided by concentration taken. So it is 101.64%. And for 120%, 100 into mean concentration found divided by concentration taken, it was 22. These are my recovery values and the end result. If you are having any doubt, you can comment me in the comment box. We'll answer it. Thank you for watching the videos.